Praise the Lord. Just lift your hand and say, tonight is my night. Say, tonight is my night. Say, Father, what eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, what has not entered the hearts of men. Lord, tonight is my night. Minister, bless me, please pray for us. Amen. Let's rise on our feet tonight. Tonight again, we are honored to have the president of Rainbow. It is a Christian youth movement. And let us celebrate God tonight as we welcome again.
Just wave your hands to Jesus where you are. Just wave your hands to Jesus. Wave your hands to Him. Where you are, just wave your hands. Just thank Him, thank Him, thank Him, thank Him, thank Him. Just worship the Lord, worship the Lord, worship the Lord. In the beauty of His holiness, worship Him, worship Him, worship Him. For you, oh,
Shut up!
Let your name be exalted. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, tonight we thank you. All that glory belongs to you. As we are about to go into your word, let there be streams of revelation. Review revelation that will bring your order in our hearts. We need you, Lord. We need you. More of your light, more of your fire. In tonight's encounter with you. When it feels for it to be the same. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let your heaven roar like thunder.
Chapter 34.
open to verse 2. And if you open to verse 2, we are going to read verse 2. From there, we are going to read verse. Let's read verse 2 first. It says, "And be ready in the morning, and come up in the morning unto Mount Sinai, and present thyself dear to me in the top of the mountain." He said, "And no man shall come with thee, neither let any man be seen throughout the mount, neither let the flocks and the herds feed." Let me run to verse 5 quickly. It says, "And the Lord descended in the cloud, stood with him there, and proclaimed the name of the Lord." This is where I'm going. He said, "The Lord descended in the cloud, stood with him there, and proclaimed the name of the Lord." Hallelujah. Tonight, the general theme says, "Thy power and thy glory." And yesterday, I was privileged by the power of the Holy Ghost to have taught you on the functionaries of the kingdom, the power, and the glory. So, we learned a lot yesterday. We learned about what the kingdom is. We learned about the true meaning of power, which we said is dunamis, from the Greek word. That power we said is from the Greek word called dunamis. That's D-O-N-A-M-I-S. But in English, we can just say D-U-N-A-M-I-S. You know, make us understand what the glory of the Lord is. We said it's the beauty of God, it's the sacredness of His beauty, the sacredness of His power, the sacredness of His might. So, tonight, the Lord wants to carry us much deeper into the teaching be tagged entering the realms of power and glory.
Amen.
Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, "Neighbor,
neighbor,
entering
into
the realms of power,
the realms of glory."
Yes. There are realms of power and there are realms of glory. Man cannot just access power. Man cannot just access glory. If it was easily accessed, everyone would walk in it. If it was easily accessed, everyone would carry the glory of God. It is not easily accessed. Means that there is a place it is kept. And until you find it, you will never want it. Even though gold is a precious stone, diamond is a precious stone, all of these are precious stones, emeralds. They are not flying all around. They are not moving on the water. They have a place there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Until you locate those places, you will never find them. That is why people have to dig to find the gold. Because they know it is there. But you must do something to get it. You must dig the ground. You must reach to the strata where it is located. If you never reach that strata, you will never see a gold. So they know their position. That's the wisdom of man. That's the wisdom of how kind of we are. What more about spiritual things? Do you think it will be flying all around? If a God can be hidden in the ground, or what more about something called the power of the kingdom? What more about something called the glory of God? Do you think it will be flying? It can never fly. There is a place it is hidden. It is left for you to locate it. Look at your neighbor, say, "My neighbor.
My neighbor,
are you ready to locate power?
Are you ready to locate power?
Are you ready to locate the glory of God?
Are you ready to locate the glory of God?"
Here is the place. And the place where the power and the glory of the Lord dwells is one realms. There are realms where these functionaries of the kingdom dwell. If you call a gold digger here, he can tell you which layer of the ground you can find a gold. He knows. a rat that he will have to dig. And when he digs that rat out, he knows that I'm about to reach the gold.
Yeah.
He knows the exact place. So it's also the realm. There are exact place in the realm of the spirit where you can find the power. The exact place in the realm of the spirit where you can find the glory. And so a spiritual man, just like a gold digger, can stand like this and tell you, this is the realm. A spiritual man can stand like this. That's how the gold digger said, you can find the glory of the Lord in this realm. And don't joke it. When you go there, you will see it. I pray for somebody tonight. The Lord is about to reveal His power to you. He's about to reveal His glory to you. In the name of Jesus, the reps, 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 they hold the power. They hold the glory. Here we saw something. The Lord wanted to channel a man that He has called in His purpose into that realm. I said, my son, you don't understand something. Let me show you something. You might have been walking in things, but they are my shadow. They are shadows of my power. And they are shadows of my glory. He said, no, come. Let me show you my real power. Let me show you my real glory. Let me bring you to a realm where you can see my power and you can see my glory.
Mm.
It is not just an ordinary person that can
desperate to see his power. Oh. And you must be desperate to see his glory. Yeah. And so the Lord knows that any man that went for him in the realm of the cloud is a serious man. So, no. What must make you pass the first realm? What must make you pass the second realm? And say, God, I'm not waiting for you in the first realm. I'm not waiting for you in the second realm. I'm waiting for you where I can see you. Why? I don't want to speak with angels. I don't want to speak with from the four elders. I don't want to speak with the saints in heaven. I want to speak with you. Then I said, this person is booking an appointment. I need to see them. I need to see them. And the Lord comes down in the cloud. And the Bible says, he came and met Moses there. That means Moses was waiting for him. Say, Papa, I am here. I'm waiting for you. And when you reach that realm, the Lord comes down. You have been waiting for me. This is me. It doesn't just come. He said, this is me in my power. And this is me in my glory. I pray for somebody tonight. As you are living from here, the Lord is revealing himself in power to you. He's revealing himself in his glory to you. In the name of Jesus. Into the inner courts of the king. That is to say, when you want to see the king, you will pass by the first court. When you want to see the king, you will pass by the second court. When you want to see the king, you will pass by the third court. Until you reach where you want to reach, they call it the inner court. If you cannot reach the inner court, if you cannot reach the court of the clouds, you cannot see his power. You cannot see his glory. If you want to see his power, enter the inner courts of the Lord. Enter the inner chambers of the Lord. Then your neighbor, enter the chamber. And she entered into the inner courts of the king. Into the inner courts. That is to say, Esther knew that if I want to see the king, he's not living in the first courts. If I want to see the king, he's not living in the second court. I must enter into his inner court. This is where I can have an appointment with him. This is where I can have a dialogue with him. Because I am where he is. A lot of us sometimes face the power and the glory because we have been waiting for the Lord in the wrong place. And once you are waiting for the Lord in the wrong place, you cannot see his power. You cannot see his glory. You must look for him in the right place. This is called the right. I pray that the Lord will increase you to that realm tonight in the name of Jesus. What is the second realm? The second realm is the realm of the hills. The realm of the hills. That is to say, this realm is the realm closer to the realm of the clouds. If a man wants to receive power in his glory, he must be in that realm before he can ascend to the clouds. If you cannot be in that realm to ascend, you will not still see it. And that's why the Lord had to come and say, come to Monsina. Because he knows, I said, no, you have to be on Mount before you ascend into the clouds. He said, come up from Monsina. He was calling him to come up to the hill. In the book of Psalm chapter 24, he said, who shall ascend into Mount the hill? If you want to access his power, you must ascend into the hill. It is from the hill you ascend into the clouds. It is from the clouds that he comes to meet you. If you cannot be at the hill, you cannot see me. Who shall ascend? Who shall ascend into the hill? You can ascend. You can ascend. As a believer, you can ascend. As a Christian, you can ascend. All you need to do is to know about these realms, and you can enter them. It is enter. highest place where I can meet the Father, where I can meet His glory, where I can meet His splendor. And He said, I need to ascend into the clouds.
I see somebody here tonight.
The Lord is ascending you to the clouds. If the man must first ascend into the hill and ascend into the clouds, he must be positioned in a realm called the holy place. If he is not positioned there, he cannot enter the hills. If he is not positioned there, he cannot enter the clouds. Before he can enter the hill and the clouds, he must be at the holy place. That was why he asked the question, who shall ascend the hill? Or who shall what? Stand in his holy place. You don't ascend to the holy place, you stand in the holy place. If you must ascend into the hill, you must stand in the holy place. That means you must be standing holy. If you are not standing holy, you cannot ascend. I pray for somebody tonight. The Lord is helping you to stand. Now you are now like a gold digger, but you know that I need to start from the point. You are starting from the point of the holy place, and when you start from that point, then now you begin to ascend into the point of the hills, and now you begin to answer the question that the Lord asked in Psalm 24, who shall ascend? You say, I am ascending. Although I am a boy, I am ascending. I might be a girl, but I'm ascending. I might be a man, but I'm ascending. I might be a woman, but I'm ascending. Because you say, who shall ascend? I am available to ascend. You need to dig more and more. You need to go beyond this layer where you are in. There is a place called my cloud. If you come to my cloud, this is where I will talk with you. Where you are, I can't talk with you. Because it is not the realm of the clouds. Beloved brethren, we are in this realm. You don't see anything around you. All you see is these clouds. All you see is white things around you. All you see is the light of God. All you see is the glory of God. It's shining bright and bright. Why? Because the clouds carry the throne of God. The clouds carry the presence of God. The clouds carry the power of God. I pray for somebody tonight. In your sleep tonight, there will be an encounter. And let us see something there. Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 4. Are you there? 3 verse 3. 3 verse 3 and verse 4. This is the cloud, the realm of the cloud. This is what you can see. He said, God came for Taman, and the Holy One from Mount Paran. See, that his glory covered the heavens, and the heavens full of his praise. Number 4, it says something. He said, and his brightness was like the light, and he had horns coming out of his hand, and there was what?
The healing power.
your heart. The Lord is revealing His power. His power is hiding in the light. The light is in the clouds. If you don't go there, you can't see the light. If you don't go there, you can't see His power. He said, and there was hiding His power. So God hid His power. For those who can ascend to the clouds, for those who can say, I'm desperate, I'm not just standing in the holy place, I'm not just ascending to the hills, Lord, I want to meet you. You are not acting like you are serious tonight. I pray for you tonight from the bottom of my heart. There is no more sinner in all you have to ascend to the hill. There is a level you will pray and you know I am not in the holy place any longer. I am now upon the hill. There is a level you will pray and you know I'm not just on the hill. I am ascending to the clouds. At this level, all you see is light around you. All you see is the clouds around you. All you see is the power surrounding you. At this time, when you are speaking in tongues, it ordinary. As you are speaking in tongues, power is coming forth.
And they come
out of prayer. Holy Ghost, bring somebody to that ground. What to pray? Yes. You can enter. You can enter. You can enter. You can enter. That prayer was not only for Moses. It's for you as well. You can enter. You can enter. If the Lord will take Moses there, the Lord will take you there. You can enter. You can enter. You can enter. Enter there. Enter there. Go there. Go there. Go there. Go there. He's looking for you. Ribs are opening. They are like potters of fire. They are like potters of fire. They are like potters of fire. Mysteries are opening. Revelations are opening. They are like potters of fire. Receive it now in your heart. Receive it now in your body. Receive it now. Elakata, 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 elakata. At the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Listen. Malika Paratus, Ila Proshata, Ile Kupa Ati, Reka Atusa. Aha, aha. There is a wing of an angel flying there. There is a wing of an angel flying there. Hey, there is an invitation. Hey, Kaato, Holy Ghost, draw them. Summon them, draw them to your inner courts, to your inner chambers. Call them, call them. Summon them, summon them. Summon them, Holy Ghost. Like you summon Moses. Like you summon Moses. Summon them. Hey, something is happening. Something is happening. Angels of fire on someone come. A sister, you are beginning to speak in tongues. You are receiving the baptism of fire. Hey, at the count of three, that will happen. 1, 2, 3. That's it. Yes. Yes. Begin to speak in the tongues of angels. Begin to speak in the tongues of angels. Continue to pray. Your visitation is here. Your visitation is here. Your visitation is here. You are entering. 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 Holy Ghost, take her there. 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 Take her there. Take her there. Repala palakata. You are entering. You are entering. You are entering. That realm is opening up to you. It's like a portal of fire. Repandish, 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 repandish. Continue to pray. When you pray like Moses did, you will enter, you will enter, you will enter. The Holy Ghost is still dealing. He's still dealing with you. He wants to deal with your heart. It is from your heart that you ascend. It is from your heart that you ascend. You ascend into his light. Where he is hiding his power. Go there. You need that power. You need that power to become successful. You need that power to overcome failure. You need that power to overcome disappointment. Receive it. Thank you. Thank you. I'm seeing two angels ministering to a sister over there. They are speaking to your ears. They are giving you message. Hey, they are showing you a burning bush now. They are showing you a burning bush. That same burning bush that Lord showed Moses. It's the same one they are showing you. It's the same one they are showing you. They are speaking mysteries and revelations to you. They are giving you message. See it over there. See it over there. See it over there. Your face cannot stand it. 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 Your face cannot stand it.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Where you are, just wave your hands to Jesus. As you are waving, you are being ushered into that realm. As you are waving, you are entering that realm. See that. Aha, aha. Holy Ghost, thank you. You have to be focused, close your eyes. Shut up. Love, blow like a mighty wind. Spirit of victory, cover us with your wings. Holy Spirit, take over my whole life is yours. Holy Spirit, do what you want. Holy Spirit, take over now. My Yahweh. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your unction. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. Thank you for an encounter. Bring us more. Bring us more into your deep courts, into your inner courts. In Jesus' mighty name, God bless us.